So I am going to punish those lying prophets for deceiving the people of Israel with false messages. I will turn against them and no longer let them belong to my people. They will not be allowed to call themselves Israelites or even to set foot in Israel. Then they will realize that I am the Lord God. Those prophets refuse to be honest. They tell my people there will be peace, even though there's no peace to be found. They are like workers who think they can fix a shaky wall by covering it with paint. But when I send rainstorms, hailstones, and strong winds, the wall will surely collapse. People will then ask the workers why the paint didn't hold it up. That wall is the city of Jerusalem, and I, the Lord God, am so angry that I will send strong winds, rainstorms, and hailstones to destroy it. The lying prophets have tried to cover up the evil in Jerusalem, but I will tear down the city all the way to its foundations, and when it collapses, those prophets will be killed, and everyone will know that I have done these things. The city of Jerusalem and its lying prophets will feel my fierce anger. Then I will announce that the city has fallen and that the lying prophets are dead because they promised my people peace when there was no peace. I, the Lord God, have spoken. Those words come from Ezekiel 13, verses 8 to 16. There are two voices that you can hear today. One voice sounds the alarm that there is danger right at the door and that we must act and act quickly or we will all perish. The other voice says, all is well. How foolish you would be to believe that things are not safe and wonderful and better than they have ever been before. This voice is the one that tells you to relax and enjoy the good times because there is no real danger. Everyone wants to believe the voice that says, all is well. It is the enticing sound of Satan that once again pulls you away from the reality of God's word. All is well if you are a follower of Jesus Christ. All is well if you have given your life to Him. All is well if your greatest desire in life is to please God by how you live each day. But if your steps are not directed by the Holy Spirit, let me assure you that all is not well. If you are not on the road to heaven, then you are indeed on the road to hell. And feeling good about the trip will not make the destination any less tragic. Lord Jesus, remind me again today that all is not well unless I am living in a personal relationship with you. And may your Holy Spirit direct my every step today and forever. Amen.